Hey guys, Paisteboy here. Today we're gonna be greasing a sealed bearing on one of the idler wheels for a snowmobile, so stick around. Since all the bearings are good on my sled, I'm going to be showing you on this one here. This appears to have come off an Articat, but the bearings should be the same. And we'll go over the tools you're going to need to do this job. First off, you're going to need some grease. I would suggest grease made for these conditions. I'm using the XPS vehicle suspension grease. This is by BRP. It's what I use on my skid, and I trust it because it's designed for the cold weather. And then you're going to need a pair of these special pliers to remove the pin on the idler wheel, or the clip, I should say. You need a little flat screwdriver, perhaps, and a pick tool. I'm not sure which one I'm going to use yet, but one of these, any one of these would do the trick, but probably one of these hooked ones. And then, of course, you're going to get an idler wheel. All right, so the first thing we need to do, there's going to be a little cap on this one. Yours may not have that, but it's got to be removed, so we're going to do a little prying on this side, on that side, until we get it out. You don't want to just force it on one side. Could break it. And there we go. That's out. That's all you need the little screwdriver for. Next, you're going to need your special pliers here. You can see there's two little holes in that clip, and we have to remove that. So, get that, put the two little pins in there, squeeze, and then it should come out. There we go. Clip removed. So it looks like there's another little cap on the other side. We're going to remove, and in this case it looks like 11/16 socket's going to fit in there nicely, and we're going to tap that out. There we go. So there's the other plastic cap, and then we have to remove the bearing from here. I suppose you don't have to. Yeah, let's see if we could grease this right while still in the wheel. But if you did have to remove it, say you had to get a new idler wheel and put the bearing in that, then you'd have to knock this out. So you'd get another socket that would fit over the inner race, which is the inner metal part of the bearing, and tap that out. But we're going to try to do it right in the idler wheel here. That's where this little pick is going to come in handy. So we'll get in there just on the edge, be careful, and pry up a little bit, move over, pry up a little bit. You don't want to damage this little plastic seal, and you can see it's coming out nicely, and there we have it. Save that, we're going to reuse it. We'll set that over there, and now you can see how that bearing looks. And you could also hear, you know, if your bearings are bad, they're going to be noisy when you spin them. You know, give them a good spin on your skid, and you're going to see that if they sound a little rough or they don't spin very well, you know, they could need to be repacked, or the bearing might just be so bad you have to replace it. But in most cases, if you're careful, you could repack it. So now we're going to take a little bit of grease there, the XPS grease, and we're going to take it. I'm wearing rubber gloves, obviously, because I don't want to get this all over myself. And grab a glove with your finger and just start working it in. To the bearings. We'll clean this up when we're done. But just start spreading it inside. Probably is better with your bare hands, but it is really greasy. So, get that out of there. All right, and now we're gonna spin. We're gonna spin that bearing a little bit. Make sure the grease is all in there good. Press it back in. Okay, and you don't want to overpack it because the grease might force its way out somewhere. So now, if we put some grease in there, you don't need a ton. Put the little seal back on. So now we're going to push the seal back on. And we'll just go around a little bit at a time. Work it in. Careful. Don't damage it. You'll kind of feel it press back in. There we go. Then I'm going to take a rag and clean the bearing surface. Clean the idler wheel. Alright, let's put our clip back in. This could be a little tricky, so make sure you got that in like that. And we'll just wipe away a little of the excess grease. And it's not completely crucial, but put our cap back on. Just that simple. And we're done. That's good for a few more seasons at least. So it's just that easy. I learned that trick from a mechanic friend of mine over 20 years ago. I actually was having some service done by him and I bought a bunch of new bearings, and then he also noticed there was a few more that still needed to be replaced. But he said, you know what? Let me show you something. And he taught me that trick. Pop the little seal off and put some fresh grease in there and you're good to go. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Share this video if you think it'll help somebody else. Click the bell to get notifications. Check the links in the description. If you like that little pick tool set, I'll see if I can find that, and we'll put a link down in the description as well. Check out the new Paisteboy merch I got, and we'll see you next time. Take care, guys. All right.